quite a length, isn't it? Quite a short stick. Oh, that's a good choice. That's what I'm saying. So how I use these steps is going to determine whether I have a chance. And I have to pay attention to how we do this, how we react to those steps. And you should react to those like saying, like, cheating, it's moving back. Cheating.
First volley?
Yeah, the goal is to only just get out of
the way. Right, okay. Because
I like to say, you can just step back at the time.
Yeah.
It's hard to do, but you have to be quite creative in how you use your set. If you used up your three sets and you're not one of the lunch, you want to try and catch up with your supreme focus, you've got to not hesitate, you've got to have a smooth focus movement. Just get the partners, position yourself more or less in the middle of the piece. Side is doing the movement, but there's other things you can do. You can make your partner stop moving. For example, a little feinting to them or even a step forward. Might make them stop. If they stop, in this context, the defender is moving. Okay? Off we go, let's see how we look at that. Yeah, this way.
Now,
we've got to be able to do a second stop. Now, stop it. Now, I don't know if you saw that, but he anticipated my step forward. and actually stepped forward before me. Did any of you spot that? Did you feel that?
Yeah.
Which is exactly what we were looking at a moment ago, wasn't it? Using rhythm. And you've got it caught out, anticipating my movement. Go again. Do you trust me?
Yeah.
No, you don't trust me. Don't trust me. You don't trust your opponent, do you? So don't trust me. I've got, never mind, the opportunity comes again. You're going to disengage, aren't you? There it is. Disengage the crap today, and he realised that he's making a little mistake on his feet. I know we can do this. Let's do it really nicely. Okay, got it. He was still shuffling around such a lot with his feet. He wasn't ready to go. There's a lot of little things can get in the way of us, aren't there? Of achieving this simple attack on preparation. Now, here is another problem. Let's see if you can introduce into it. Everybody was doing it slightly differently, which was interesting to see. But I started making a mistake as a coach, and I was making this mistake. And I was coaching this exercise with practice. What was said by me? Started stepping back in response to my foot movement, and then you get the signal for doing the attack. Your back foot's not on the ground, you find you can't attack. You see? That's what happens. So I was, as a coach, I was thinking, oh, I'll make a mistake. And then I thought, well, hang on, fences are going to do that all the time, aren't they? It's not always going to be very focus. So the way you are going to still be able to attack is like saying, don't trust me. I might appear to be moving forward. Don't move back until my back foot actually moves. Don't move from the spot to my front foot because you might get a chance to attack. I'm not going. Go for the lead. You've got a chance to attack. If your feet are the loose on the floor, you can go. But if the back foot moves, then you've got to step back. See if you can do that. So we're talking about what I referenced through there, predominantly immobile style moves. You're not really going to jump around and move around because you want to be ready to go. You see, you responded to the front foot, ignore the front foot, now the back foot goes, good. So I'm never in distance, he doesn't let me get into distance. See how he wants to move his feet all the time, doesn't he? Good, he's a bit late in his step. Ah, never mind. But see, because you moved too early, you couldn't do the attack. There was an opportunity there, you could have exploited it if you hadn't moved so early. If I picked a different fence, you know, because people move in different ways, they would be able to do it just because of the way they move, not because they're better, because they're not so quick on their feet. That's the thing. Good, good. You waited there. Yes! Just about coming. A little shuffle, and he went. Okay, difficult, isn't it? Anyway, partly because of your style of how you move. You want to move all the time. It makes it hard to do these kind of attacks, doesn't it? Now, what I want you to do with your partner this time, do your attempt to find a lane a bit later. Because that's going to be the right kind of thing that you're going to do this attack on preparation case. And see if you can change the timing between your blade and your foot. Foot, blade.
See if you can do that. But the attacks only happen when you've got a combination of a blade action and a foot action going forward. Just get the part a little bit more with this particular exercise, see if you can make those little changes.
Thank you.
try that out. Try the heat a little bit, and then try the whole thing. See if you can get that going. Steps back. Smack his leg. Nothing.
Attack him. If he doesn't move, attack him with the 1-2. There you go.